In Storyline, you can create states for just about any object. And a state is really just a different way of displaying your object. Like here's an example where I've got a character on my slide. And down here in the states panel, you can see I've created these three custom states for her. Each one has a different expression, a different pose, and I even inserted a little caption to show what she's saying. Now, a lot of times when we create states, we use triggers to cause the right state to appear based on how the learner interacts with your content. And that's really easy. Like on this slide, what I've done is I've got these three rectangles that look like sticky notes. And when the learner clicks on one of these, I want the character's state to change to either sticky one, sticky two, or sticky three. So to make that happen, I just created some triggers over here in my trigger panel, and I'll just open up this first one so you know what I mean. It's really easy. You just tell Storyline what you want to have happen and when. So I'm saying change the state of the character to the state that I've called sticky one when the user clicks on rectangle one, which is this one right here. And then I created a similar trigger for each of those others. So what happens is when the learner encounters the slide, they click on, you know, one of these, and you can see how her expression and her pose and her caption is changing. So states can be a really fun way of creating interactivity. Now, if you need a little more help with triggers, we do have another tutorial on that. So we'll give you the link at the bottom of the written states tutorial in eLearning Heroes. I also wanted to tell you, though, that some states are built-in states that Storyline provides, and these will show up automatically at the right time without a trigger at all. Like in this example, on this sticky note, I applied a hover state down here in my states panel, and I don't need a trigger for that because hover is a built-in state that Storyline totally understands. Storyline's going to show that state automatically when learners hover over the object. So let's see how we can add a state to an object. Let's say that we want to give a hover state to this character. So we're going to come down here to our states panel. And by the way, if you're not seeing these panels down here, it probably just means that they're closed. Probably looks like this. So what you can do is come down to the lower right and click on this little arrow here, and that's going to make those panels visible. So we're going to click Edit States, and then I want to click on this New State button. And then here's where I can select the state or type my new state name. Now, if I want to create a custom state, I would just, you know, type a name in here of whatever I wanted to give it, like I did, you know, for sticky one, sticky two, and sticky three. Or you can select one of the built-in states. And for illustrated characters, you'll have a ton of choices here that Storyline will give you. You'll also have some of these other common built-in states that you can choose from, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to select hover, and then we'll click add. And now our state's created, and we just need to customize how it looks. So up here on my character tools, what I'm going to do is click my design tab. I'm going to change this character's expression. I'm going to have her be asking something, and I'm going to have her hands out to the sides. And let's also put a caption in this one too, just like we did for the other couple of states that I created. I've got some text I'll just paste in there that says click on the sticky notes, and we'll make that a little bit bigger. So that's pretty much all I want to do. Now when you're done, you can click Done Editing States down here in the States panel. Or if you want to add or edit some states on a different object on your slide, you can come over here to this drop down, and then you can use this to jump to whatever object on your slide that you want. And that's just a little quicker than having to close the States panel and then select a new object and, you know, open the panel back up. So we're done here. I'll go ahead and say Done Editing States. And now if we preview this, we'll see how our hover state looks on our character. So there she is. And then when we hover, we get her expression and her pose changes, and we see the caption that we created. So that's just what we wanted. Now, one more thing down here in this states panel that I want to mention. You can also control the state that an object is initially in. And this can come in kind of handy. This little dropdown lets you do that. It's going to list the states you can choose from, as well as a state called hidden, which of course means that initially the object is going to be hidden until something triggers it to be in some other state. And that can be really nice. Like if you want to make something start out as hidden, but then change it to maybe the normal state or some other state when the learner, I don't know, when they click on something or when they do something else on the slide, it's up to you. You can create a trigger for that, and it can be a really nice way to add interactivity. Now, if you ever decide that you want to get rid of states or a particular state on an object, that's really easy to do too. You just select the object, click Edit States, and then select the state that you don't want anymore. And then you can either hit your delete key or you can click on this little red X, and that'll help you remove that state if you need to. So that's a quick look at adding and editing states in Articulate Storyline. I hope that helps.